Okay, once again, welcome to TWR Facebook Live. I am terribly, terribly sorry and apologize for this event, lack of knowledge of technology. But I promise all of you, we are doing our best, trying to improve every time. And what happened was, you know, the Facebook app was open on my computer. So when I'm talking, it was going live out, but then the Facebook was feeding back to me on my screen. So that was a problem. So it's taken care. So I wanted to, first of all, so excited about this and looking, waiting for this for a long time. And so I'm so happy to have Gishe Losan Tsenila here, and member Yangdu Kazanla, and member Punzo Wang Wamula, and also member Kunga Wangdila, and all of you, first of all, welcome. And number two, Tsangma Taishdile, Tela Taishdile Shuei. And Toma Ya Tsikashiji, Pogena, this is Shugo Samsung. Sorry, I will say a few words in Tibetan to all my Tibetan friends. So, Toma Delia. Jab some mind by Mozu Negi indicate Shetawada, the kid, the Kiri Minda with Chubdin Tola, Tizuchik Tola, Kiri Mira Chubdin Tola Jugure. Then the Indianata, numbers of talents in a chick, indicate a purgatory, jugging a talent in Yana, and a Tesh Delishugi, and a team maybe in a Nega, and a Mozu indicate Nala Shishovachi, and a Tamatella Tangozu Jugdum Della. Member Wandula, TCG, Monzu, come now to the Samachi, Induda, which is so Duru Nangres or Wandula Tibugushai. Ah, Chirangi. So that was it in Tibetan. So I wanted to again welcome everybody. And I'm so excited about, you know, many of our cyber Sangha here being a spiritual practitioner, meditator, very much. Conscious of about well-being, health, and mind. So Tibetan medicine is, I think, one of the very important ancient tradition, which contains a lot of wisdom about mind and body connection. So it does not see the body and mind as something separate. It sees very much together, and particularly how much our health of body is being influenced by our mind. And so this is the speakers here are experts in the field, and so I am very, very excited to hear each one of them. So first of all, I would like to start with member Wang Dula, and who is living in New York. Maybe just maybe if you want to introduce a little bit yourself, your education, and where you live. And then I know like Wangdila is going to talk basically the cause conditions and also about cause conditions of our well-being, and also about the imbalance and balances of five elements principles. So please welcome Wangdila.
Hello, everybody. Tashi Dele, and my name is Dr. Kunga Wangdu. I was graduate from Tibetan Medical and Astrological Institute, Dharamsala, And then I practice Tibetan medicine almost like 20 years now. And right now I'm living in New York. So that's very brief introduction of myself. And today my topic is about the cause and condition of mental illnesses, or which is related also with the physical illnesses, physical disorders. So and according to Tibetan medicine or Tibetan Buddhism, and we have the mind and the body are not separate. And the mind and the body are separate when we die. So when we are alive, we always have relationship between mind and body. So since we are talking about the mental issues, mental problems today, so it's very important to know that what is the cause of the mental issues and what is the conditions of the mental issues that, you know, arises from the cause. So I just want to mention briefly in a short word that the ultimate the mental cause of the mental disorder is from the ignorance, which we always talk about ignorance. And ignorance means that the lack of the knowledge about the intrinsic the nature of our mind or the things around us. So this is the ignorance. So maybe a lot of the people, when you guys go to the Tibetan monastery or Tibetan temple, you guys see those pictures outside of the Tibetan temples or the monastery. There's the wheel of life. You can see. I got a picture for that. So I just show you a little bit so you can get a little information about this one. You guys see this one, right? The wheel of life. Wheel of life. So this one in the center, let me try to find this one. This one in the center, there's a pig and there's a snake and there's a bird. So these are called three mental poisons. These are the cause of the mental disorders. And these are comes from the ignorance. So ignorance is the root cause for all the mental conditions or mental disorders, mental the imbalances. So those three mental poisons. Why they are called mental poisons? Because these are the afflictive emotions, the negative emotions or negative thoughts that accumulate all the karmas, like negative karmas, which is the cause for the cyclic existence of life. So this is the wheel of life. And so these are the cause of all the mental imbalances or mental the illnesses. And then we have ignorance and then three mental poisons. And three mental poisons also brings those first of all, I just want to tell a little bit about three mental poisons. The first one is the hatred, and then we have attachment, and then we have the delusions. So the hatred, attachment, delusion, those called three mental poisons. So we have thousands of the thoughts, and we have the different kinds of mental the what they call negative mental states. So if we categorize those in three different categories, that's called three mental poisons: hatred, desire, and attachment. So those are the thing that make us the problems in our mind. Yeah. So for example, when someone has a great hatred towards something or someone, and then that's the cause that makes a lot of the mental problems, especially this effect with the three principal energies. Three principal energies are Lung, Tiba, and Pagan. So the mental so this is the course. And then after this, then we talk about conditions. I think we will go a little bit more detail in the next round. So this is, we only have like 5 or 10 minutes. So that's why. And then we have conditions that arise those problems. You know, there are, since we have the course with us when we exist in the cyclic existence of life. So there are some causes which contribute, you know, which accumulate and which arise those mental problems and then manifest as a disease. So that's what we have the time and to the se jualam, the time and season, and then the negative spirit influence, and then diet, and then behaviors. Those are the causes for the those mental negative influences arise, and it's become a disorder, mental disorder. So once we have mental disorder, and then we have those all kinds of treatment and through the medications and therapy and the psychologists and the religious practice, or which is the mental training. And then we also have those se chu men je, and se the diet and behavior and medication and therapy. So these are the, you know, the treatment that we Tibetan doctors we give to the mental patients. So I think this is a little bit very, very little information about cause and conditions. So we will go more detail. Thank you, Rupsila.
Thank you, Dr. Vandula. Thank you very much. I know this topic is very, very profound, very complex, and it's very, very difficult to know where to cover these issues in 5-10 minutes. So I appreciate very much. So what I understand, Dr. Vandula, basically core principle is saying that, of course, as a human disease is part of our samsaric package. When we come, moment we are born on this earth, we come with them. But it does not necessarily mean that we have to use all those problems at the same time. I think Tibetan medical system definitely discussed a lot about prevention methods and with what you eat, your mental attitude, your behavior. And I think these are, I'm sure we're going to talk afterward more. So basically, you can prevent a lot, and you can minimize, and you can, and also slow down the process of sickness because of these ancient knowledges. So thank you so much. And the second speaker is Dr. Yamnila from California. Also, I will ask you to say a few words about yourself and your work. And then Dr. Yamnila, particularly going to speak, I think it's a very interesting topic, is about, we say what we say, Soglung and Yinglung. So basically, this is also about the wind, the lung, prana, and particularly related to our heart and our life force, so which definitely has so much to do with our well-being. If they are balanced, if they are not balanced, it's a little bit like that about breathing. What I read is that in one day, we breathe about 11,000 liters of air in one single day. Every minute, about 7 to 8 liters of air we breathe in. Of course, not all air is oxygen. So that's 550 liters of oxygen that we breathe in. So if you don't breathe, you die in 10-15 minutes. If you cannot drink water, you can stay or weeks. If you don't eat, you can stay even longer than that. So days, sorry, the water in days, and they're not eating weeks, you can stay. So, but air is really, really important. And then this notion of Soglung and Yinglung are more important because our heart and vitality has been very important. So I'm very much looking forward to Dr. Yamnila. Please go ahead.
Yes. Good morning, everyone. Can you hear me, Rumutila? Okay, good morning. Yes, my name is Yangrong Kiaosang, and I live in San Francisco. I originally came from Lhasa and educated on Tibetan medicine in Lhasa Medical School, we call University of Tibetan Medicine. And I have been living in the West for last 20 years and also carrying on practicing Tibetan medicine along with my life here. And this is one of the most interesting topic and subject for me to share with everyone, because once you're in the life, you really see what people are suffering and you can tell how you can help through Tibetan medicine. And thank you so much, Dr. Wundula, made such a wonderful introduction of cause and conditional cause of mental imbalances or mind-body imbalances. So a lot of us go through this without knowing, or some of them you have a tiny bit of problem. Your doctor, either doctor or yourself, diagnose yourself, I'm being diagnosed with the depression, anxiety, panic, etc. So I like to use this opportunity for you and for me to share this common point where you can find yourself, when to bring yourself to see this point of moment, that when do you have the imbalances of mind and body? Because at this stage, even if you go to your doctor, Western doctor, allopathic doctor, you do your MRI, you do your X-ray, you do your blood test, no matter how fancy the test will be, it will not be really showed in the test result. But as a patient, or the person will go through different discomforts. So I want to start with the, I kind of categorize them into mental feeling and, or emotional feeling, and also as well as the physical feeling. So in general, when you look at the person tends to be liking to eat what we call as a junk food. They don't like to really nourish. I want to be really low fat diet. I want to keep myself skinny. I want to keep myself good shape, which is nice. But a lot of times those people develop some type of lung conditions, and their body tends to be cold easily, susceptible for cold or breeze. And for us, most people live in the West, we have air conditioning inside the building all the time. So that counts as a, one of the source of breeze or the cold wind expression, because that can produce a lot of pain as well as the emotional imbalances. And then a lot of people tell me that they feel cold on their hands, on their feet. And when you look at their finger, it's bluish color and really pale. When you look, it can be either pale or dark bluish color. So people living in the colder weather, you will experience that as well. And one of the most interesting part of the person would be very talkative. And they can be talking to themselves. They can be talking something that not makes makes a sense, but it also does not need to be making sense. So they will go over something. They will tell you everything about it from top to bottom, and they may not be connected, but they like to talk. So they will talk, talk, talk. And when you see in the clinic, you can see what kind of person is this, what kind of people. Some people with different constitution, they do not really talk that much. And I just want to go back to Dr. Undus. He used the terminology of lung tiba pagan. So the lung is the one actually based on our five elements in Tibetan medicine. It's air, or the wind related. So that's the one majorly affect in our mental and body imbalances. And another thing is that the person can become really sensitive to noise, to lights, to everything. They cannot really sleep well, fall asleep. They wake up easily and they cannot fall asleep. They're thinking so much. Another word we normally describe is a monkey mind. So they get many thoughts but cannot really follow through. And this is the one thing. And another thing is they kind of really like to sing a song, which is great. and they like to laugh without much reasons. And also they like to argue, they like to fight. We in Tibetan medicine, we actually say to fight with something, but like making more argument, being really critical. Something is too, even if someone did something good for you, it either is too long, too short, too hot, too cold. Anyway, they will find a reason to complain. So make other people uncomfortable. And those are the signs and symptoms. And also what they have is they get a lot of good ideas, but they cannot really follow through. So those are the mental connection that what you can catch yourself where you are. And the person prefers to eat sweet, sour, and spicy or pungent food or flavored snack. And in terms of the physical body, they probably feel shaking easily and trembling. So at this moment, we're not really diagnosing any serious condition, but this is the early stage. And shivering is the one common thing that they do have, and night sweat and hot flashes. So all those symptoms that really connect with the lung. And also lung physically, in terms of their, some of the pain, it's not stable, it's not localized, it moves around. So sometimes, for instance, you have a headache. The headache is on the top of your head one moment, the other moment is on the temporal area, the other moment is on your occipital region, it moves around. So it's not stable. So I think probably this much, I used up my minutes. I hope that's covered enough information.
Oh, Dalai Andrela, Tuji Che, thank you. Thank you very much. So I think it's a very, very interesting all aspect of the Tibetan medicine, that how, you know, it has so much to do with the cause, conditions. There is no such, nothing is fixed here, and everything is possible to change, possible to prevent, possible to be aware. So I think these are the more and more we learn about our body, conditions of our body, and it might be very different from another person, so that more like able to work with your own need specifically, rather than very general advices. This is one thing during the conference in Virginia, Serenity Ridge, Dr. Yandela was talking, and I thought it was very interesting, is just generally in the West that there's always a very advices that is given to everybody. For example, some people believe in a low fat, so avoid fat. And some people are low carb and avoid all. So even the egg yolks, you know, like it's not good for everybody. Now science finding is that no, even though yolk has cholesterol within them, but not necessarily corresponds to affecting cholesterol in the heart, you can eat now. So many years of not eating, now suddenly you can eat, but then it's also for everybody. So I don't think that Tibetan medicine is really talks like that. It really makes you understand that you each individuals are very differently designed, either your gene or your upbringing, the conditions that you have met, and the nutritions that you got or you did not got. So every current body is a very unique body. You really have to understand that alone itself and to figure it out. So this is, I think, is a very interesting. I hope that all of you can cover more of that. Next speaker is here, Dr. Punzola. Let me unmute you first. What's happening?
Le jambuji seng du gel.
Oh, d'accord.
Voilà, so.
Chegi, please say a little bit about yourself and also the Shangyung Institute, the way you're working. And I just wanted to let everybody know, all the speakers know, that our great host, Anya, have all the informations of each one of your particular work. And as you have been talking, Anna is posting all the website and your information there. And also, all those you're listening to here, please remember that if anything seems interesting by any speakers, you can always go back. Anya has posted the link and website to get more information, their publication, their where they can meet, how you can contact them, and so on. Thank you so much. Pansola, go ahead.
Lasso Katinchi. Thank you, Rinpoche, and everybody. Sorry, today I'm in the outdoor. Somehow, suddenly our internet cut it, so I cannot use the computer. But it's nice outside. It's nice weather, so also somehow it's lucky. So, okay, so thank you, the two previous speakers, and then also Rinpoche. The two previous speakers explained in general conditions about the disease. So, but the Tibetan medicine is when we looking the cause of the disease, as Dr. Gunga Wondula, he said, when we're looking the cause of the disease, can be caused is through the diet behave. And not only through the diet behave, many of us, we thinking the cause of disease must be either wrong food or the wrong behave. But also there's another one important or the like a critical cause of the disease is also the seasonal and also environment. So the each season we changing, there is a meaning, because is the season changing, the temperature is changing, element is changing. So same as like that, we also in our body mechanism also changing. So when we're looking previous speakers, so when we're looking this, the lung element, which is air element or the wind element. So the air element or the wind element is one of the five elements. It's very important in our body. Normally is like air element is that the what we comes through the, our breathing. And the function is all the movements, actions, mental activities, thinking, thoughts, and also circulating the, all the liquids, including the blood. But that the air element, if the air element is balanced time, or the five element balancing time, and then they're working as a team to maintain the healthy body and the healthy mind. Same as like outer nature, all the five element outer nature is balanced. We will have a good summer, good autumn, good crops, good flowers, so on and so forth. If that's not balanced time, then we'll have, which we call is a natural disaster. Same as like that way, our inner, our body, five element imbalanced time, also that can causing us losing our life, or the major problem is losing life, and the minor problem is making suffering to the physical body and the mind. As Rinpoche said, is this the breathing is important? How important is the breathing? Every second day breathing certain numbers of the breath, and some of them is oxygen, some of them is not necessarily oxygen, but is body needed. So when we look in this, how important the air element, but the more important is the balance of the air element. If the air element is excess, as the Dr. Yang Zhengla mentioned before, we will have all type of symptoms of the mental issues, like anxieties, panic, not able to sleep, and then stress, so on and so forth. But also there is a problems, ear element deficiency. So if the excess is there is a problem, deficiency also there is a problem. So when we comes into the, this is not only in the air element, all five elements, if the imbalance, so then we will have the problems. So the my today's main topic is that the winter, how should care of the winter? Why is the winter? The winter is the, in the weather comes to cold, and then night is longer, day is shorter, and also more so like a cohesive, condensed, like everything come to the peace, cold, calm, included also birds is not moving, all the underground animal is go back to the underground, and then the flying animals like birds, they go to the other warm nature place. Which means is the when the weather is cold, as there is not life. So for that reason, what happened in our body? It's in our body is we the body is sort of like a like automatic, is very smart body system. So what they do is they shut down the all the pores, try to keep the heat inside. Same as like what we do. Maybe many of the listeners, audience are living into like a warm climate in the winter. So maybe for them is, it does not make maybe so sense. But we like who live in the Tibet or in the North America or many other regions. Like winter for us, we need the heat, turn on the heat, close the windows. Once we turn on the heat, if we open the windows, all the heat goes out. For that reason, important to close the window, not only close the window, but also many countries we have like the double windows. So which means is that the important to keep the heat inside to protect the people in the building, prevent from the frozen, prevent from the like unable to move. Same as like that way, in the winter comes, the body pores, they shut down to keep the heat inside to protect the organs. So this one is also one usage of the preventing the disease. And also the another one is to like, we can say sort of like to cure the disease. So when is the winter? So winter is in the Tibetan month, in the lunar calendar. It's 9th, 10th, and 12th. The 9th, 10th, 11th is the winter for like 3 months of the winter. But in the Tibetan medicine, what we did is that the, in our seasons, so we our season in generally, there are 4 seasons, and the 2 like transition seasons. So we have 2 solstices, 2 equinoxes. The summer solstice is the middle of the summer. The winter solstice is the middle of the winter. And then the spring solstice, I mean the equinox is the spring. And then autumn equinox is the middle of the autumn. So then 2 transition. So for that reason, we in the Tibetan medicine, we have 6 seasons. Because 2 transitions. So when we look in the winter, we have early winter and the later winter. So the early winter starting in the Tibetan lunar calendar in the 9th and then the 10th month. And then the later winter is the 11th and the 12th month. So the first day of the Tibetan New Year, which we call as Losar, and that is the first day of the spring in Tibetan lunar calendar. So that pretty much related to when we translate into like Western, I mean, today's our international, like the calendar, November, December is like early winter, and the January and the February is later winters. So then sometimes as a lunar calendar, we have little shift days, but it's basically that's the one. So those two different parts of the winter, what happening? The first month of the winter, like the 9th or the November, is all the elements going down to the ground. Even is like the Tibetan medicine, like the herbology. So at that time, no one harvesting the plants because all the energy is going down to the ground. So it at that time, all the root medicine is more powerful. Same as like that, we also, we as a human or any other animals, also we tend to see gain weight. Also, this is also cycle of the sun and the moon. The moon energy is more powerful than the sunlight because sunlight is shorter, moonlight is longer, and so on and so forth. So when that happened, time, and then it's the two important things. One is the to understanding the season of the winter, and to find out is the what is the diet. So that is the important. So, okay, so first round, I will stop here, and then I will continue with more explain to the nature of the food and so on and so forth. Thank you.
Well, thank you, Dr. Punzola. Let me unmute and unmute. Okay, so thank you so much. So I will, now our next speaker, we have Lobsang La. And Lobsang La is going to have been doing a lot of work in teaching meditation in prison. And so basically Lobsang La is going to speak about the how does the mindfulness healing works. And somehow, you know, all the defects in our body, the issues in our body, in mind, has so much to do with our ability to control our mind or not able to stay calm and cool and playful or not. So I think looking forward to hearing from you. Please go ahead and say a few words about you yourself. And then, of course, Anya will be posting all the information about you. So thank you. Please go ahead. Unmute 최고고요, 럽상라 고금인도. Hello.
Volume 대충 정도.
Oh yeah, 딱 고고도. 원님도 체로 당나나?
원님 체로 당나나?
야구시라 고우면도 애네 원님도 체로 당 양나디 꼬시안에 디게로
Hello everybody 다 보고도 가도 고우도
야구시안 다 야구 고우도
Okay, let's Hello everybody welcome everybody and thank you Rinpoche and Anya So if organizing such a great, wonderful event. And thank you very much for my friends in here participating with me here now. And so I would like to talk a little bit about the connection between mind and body, which at the beginning, Dr. Wong Dula already mentioned about it in the opening talk. And so here, So when we talk about mind and body relationship, so which Ondula already mentioned, three nyepas or long tipa pekan. And so if you understand all these three and how to cooperate with your mindfulness practice, that would be great. The preventive care. So that's why I would like to a little bit elaborate on that, how to use mindfulness for your preventive care. So as the Dr. Wondula mentioned about the Tibetan medicine, so Sejo Menje, so there is a diet and behavior and then medicine therapy and so on. So at the first two, diet and the behavior is a very important to prevent your further developing more serious sickness. For example, when you're eating, if you eat by mindfully, so that means you can eat more slowly and be more mindfully, and so that helps. Sorry, my dog is pulling my power cord. So when you eat, you should eat mindfully, like, you know, chew well, bite enough, don't just like, you know, shove in your mouth and swallow in and then just go to work right away. So even though you eat like, you know, 10 bites only, if you take this bite very mindfully and chew well, so that when you're chewing, so it produces more enzyme. So when the enzyme, more enzyme you have, it goes to your body in your stomach and digests properly. So in Tibetan medicine says, means all the undigest, all the sickness, internal sickness you have is come from the undigest. So if you don't chew properly, and then more your stomach and your all the digestive system have more trouble to work harder to digest all the food that you have eaten. And so that's why it is very, very important to having your eat mindfully. And then second one is behavior. So behavior is the body behavior and mentally behavior. So here I'm talking about a little bit about the mental behavior. So mental behavior, when you talk mindfully. If you walk mindfully, right? If you don't talk mindfully, you use such a harsh words, and then it creates more trouble for the other people and as well as yourself, get more stress. So then all the stress that release a lot of hormones, stress hormones, so on. So that stress hormone, so on, they accumulate in your body every single time. And it gradually it develops like, you know, huge problem. So it's like a drop of the water can make a hole on the stone, right? On the rock. So same thing, like, you know, I'm a little bit stressed today, but it's adding up and releasing all those hormones in your body that continues in your body accumulated and then creates such a big problem. So the so what I'm saying is being mindful, eat mindful, talk mindful, everything be mindful, and then there will be the best diet you have. So balancing diet is the best diet you have. Thank you.
Last two. So you hear me okay? Okay. So thank you so much. It was fantastic and very, very interesting. And I think all conversation you hear, our first speaker to the second and the third and fourth, all are basically connected to each other. So maybe the second round of conversation, I would request all of you, maybe the same sequence, Dr. Wondula, maybe same sequence with talking a little bit about more what we can do today. So maybe less theoretical part. So what we can actually, I can start right now in terms of the balancing the winds and elements, five elements. And then as again, the same thing, Dr. Pundola, about, okay, winter care, what should I drink and not drink and eat and not eat and so on. So I think maybe some practical advices that I think probably we all are looking forward. And well, some of you, we are living in California, the weather is a little bit better, but somewhere in Northern Europe, maybe they definitely wanted to hear a little bit more about how to cope with the winter here. So let's kind of start with that. So Dr. Wondula, you want to go?
Oh, yes, Rinpoche. Thank you for everyone. Everybody, that gives very good talks on the topic. It's very interesting, and I can also learn a lot from those topics. So thank you so much. Now this is the thing is that how Tibetan medicine can help the mental problems. So in order to know that, we first thing the one of the most important thing is that we have to know there is a very close connection between mind and body. So this is very important. Anything we do for the mental health or the physical health. So first thing, we have to know how those two things are connected, how those two things can influence each other, how those two things can help each other, improve each other's, the health. So this is one of the key thing, you know, if we wanna learn about the mental problem and the physical problems and its connections. And so I would like to say a little bit about, you know, the connections between mind and body and where it comes from. And so it is the how mind and the bodies comes together. It starts with we all are our life is starting with the conceptions in the mother's wombs. So we say that what it says that pai ku e rubal the thangbu pame ku ja gyem me nam shi le dang yum ki gun jung a chob ngi de chak ba kyu. This is what is this saying is that we need to have a union of father's sperm, a healthy sperm, and then and also the organs from mother. And on top of that, we need to have a consciousness of a being which has the past karmic influence. And then we also have those, you know, like the equal qualities of the five elements. So those are the cause of the conceptions. When we have those three things, three components in the same place in together, and then we have a fetus, then we have a baby in a womb. So this is the cause. So if you think very carefully, that's you know, like the mind and the body and the elements comes together in the one place. That's the starting point. That's the life started. So when we start our life, those three things need to become good together. Otherwise, there will be no fetus. There will be no baby. So this is the one of the starting points.
So the question here is, so how do we actually do it?
All right.
Today, you know, this morning when we started to have the online thing, the internet went wrong and everything went wrong. So how do we actually do that? I mean, in tips that maybe can be beneficial and helpful.
Conceptually,
I think people some sense we understand okay how that it works, but in a real life, real situation, what should people do?
Oh yes, Nimbujala. So to get a pregnancy, we should have a very healthy sperm from the father and very healthy from a mother. So this is that something. If you have any problems with the lung, especially the wind disorders, we should treat it. Otherwise, the wind disorders. There are many cases that you know some of the father or the mother they don't have enough quantities of the sperm and you know the not healthy eggs, so this also can cause the problems for the conceptions, problems to get the pregnancy. So there I have a lot of the patients, they have the problem with the getting baby, and then they come to us and then we check the pulse. They have a huge accumulation of wind with them, and then they have the wind energy imbalance. So we should treat that, and we should keep like we should have the good source of nutritional food, and we should have a very healthy mind. We should have a very peaceful mind, and all those things are very necessary, very important to get a pregnancy, to get at the conceptions. So this is one practical thing step. And then after that, then we have those three connections together. So here, why I'm mentioning those three things, because those three things, the father's sperm and the mother's egg, they are in the nature of five elements. And then there's a conception, there's a, the consciousness of a being. This also says there is a very subtle, the subtle natures of the five elements present there. And then we also have Pama, and then the consciousness. So this need to be present there and five elements equally. Otherwise, if there's imbalanced, if there's excess, if there's the deficiency, and then we're not gonna become the
So, for example, yeah, in terms of the conceptions, I understand that you need a father, you need the mother, then also the blood and the sperm, and then also the consciousness. But what about the same principle of balances of body and mind, balances of five element, the current moment, like right now, as we are speaking right now, if I look at myself, so mm-hmm. I have a body and mm-hmm. I have a mind mm-hmm. and is the my mind aspect of five element in my mind, then aspect of element in my body, are they together or not? Is my awareness is participating as a conception? Is awareness is participating or not? If awareness is a participating, then if any action that I wanted to give a birth, like an action of joy or action of love or action of some creative thing, but the action only going to come if my awareness participating in my body and the plan of my mind, right? The principle will apply similar. So maybe... Yes. Something like that, maybe people might helpful.
Yes, Rinpoche. Yes, Rinpoche. That's exactly the people have to know that, because the mind and body and elements, the five elements. You know, that as Rinpoche said, that we are here today, right now. I'm moving my hands and I'm talking. So all those activities, all those movements, comes from those energies. Those five elements. When we talk about five elements in terms of medical level or in terms of a clinical level, in terms of treatment, we call them three principal energies, which we call Lung, Tiba, and Pagan. So Lung means the equal the meaning of wind energy, and then Tiba is the energy of fire element. So this is, and then Pagan is earth and water. Again, it's very old, the language that we've used in Tibet on like 1,000 years before. Again, and then we have a space element present in with all of those five elements. So whatever we do, everyday life in the morning to evening time, we go to the office, we go to the street, we go to the restaurant, eat, whatever we do, what our body activities, whatever we moving, and those are because of the contribution of those five elements or the five three principal energies. And then mind also has those five elements and with the three principal energies. Those are the like bridge which bring those mind and body together, because they share the nature. The mind also has the qualities or the quantities of the equal quantities of the five element, body also. So they share the nature. So that's why the five element and three principal energy are the bridge between mind and body. So that's the connections.
Okay,
so
thank you. Yes,
Rinpoche. When we lose that connections, then we have all kinds of problems. And whether you are thinking something, you're doing something, you know, you think to go there and you think to catch up a pen, but you cannot catch because it is dropped, because there's no connection. We lose the connections. Okay. Yes, Rinpoche, you're asking me something.
Yeah, thank you. No, thank you. So I think maybe we will time is short, so we'll maybe move on with Dr. Punsola. Please just go ahead.
Okay. Describe. Can't hear you. Can you hear me? I lost you. I can't hear you.
Kogu mide.
Oh, ta kogu.
Ale keje ma sherwa ti ma gore.
tongbo cha bin bre
tongbo cha la sana sona la
koto shan de gore
lai
okay so once again thank you for watching staying with us and Dr. Kungala made such a wonderful connection of the mind and body, how they're reciprocally related. So this is a very fundamental theory you need to know. And then once you know, what we need to do is how to cope with these conditions, right? The symptoms that we mentioned, some of the basic signs that you can recognize yourself, we have talked about, and even Dr. Wondula mentioned we need to treat it, right? Once you have it. So through the Tibetan medicine, in terms of treatment, we just don't go forward as a, medication right away. So there's the levels of different categories. You apply for diet and nutrition, lifestyle and behavior, and herbal remedies. Then you go to the external therapies, but when you are having this type of little things, you may not necessarily need everything. So maybe later on when we have a minute that Dr. Ondula can talk a little bit about food, what you can eat for the lung. But on the other hand, what I am going to focus on is external therapy. We call HORME, spells as HOR/MEY. And this is a warming or hot therapy, and we use oil. So medically we use, and we can also use as a self-care. So I brought a little demo and a few things together. You can get this thing very easy. Can you see this? Not really well, right? But it's a nutmeg. So let me put it on little white paper. Maybe you will see a little better. Oh, I just give the name, so it's harder to see. It's a nutmeg shell with a whole nutmeg. And then you can get some caraway seeds. So when you have this tool, because this is a really warming herbs and also nourishing for the lung, for the in terms of lung, we need something to bring the lung down because it's an excess case at this moment we're dealing with. So we need some nourishing means nutritional, warm. It needs to have the warm property. So particularly we use a nutmeg and caraway seeds are the two main things. Then other thing what we need is that we can either use a ghee as a clarified butter or sesame oil. So you really need these two things or three things together for yourself. For emergency use, what you can do is that in case you get all of a sudden you fight with your boss or you have some big argument, you cannot breathe, you got a little panic attack, you know, you're locked in the room, something. What you can do is you take a deep breath. But if you have some handy of nutmeg and caraway seeds powder, you smell it. You just ingest the through your nose just to smell and inhale the smell. That will help you to relieve the emergency or the urgent care. It will get rid of the condition at that moment. But when you have a little better condition at home, what you can do is you heat them up. You can use something called cup warmer. So it's something like this. You put a candle in, then you put the herbal poultice in. So what you do is you just grind both of the herbs that we mentioned. You make a poultice, like something like this. So it's just the powder of the herbs that you we talked about. You mix them together. Then you put inside this. You put a little bit oil, heat it up. So once you heat up, you're going to apply for a few points. There are a few points that are very easy. You can do it right away. Those points are palms. You have two palms, most of them. Most of us, then you use the palms and you use the sole, 2 points, 4 points right there. Then on the crown of the head, where is your crown of the chakra, you can put that and a little bit in the front nail. So it's about 4 finger breadth forward. Then another 8 8 finger breath back, then you can use on your temporal. It really helps you to relieve a lot of tension and anxiety. And another thing is you can put, you can put it right between the sternum, on the sternum bone, right between the breast area. You kind of palpate along with it where you feel the most tendon or tenderness or tightness or soreness area. You can use that point. So that's a one option you can do. Another option is for a lot of kids, they don't like the heat or they don't like this. You can just make a little small pouch with these two herbs, put under the pillow when they feel cannot fall asleep or difficult falling asleep, when they feel really anxiety. Adults can do that too. You just inhale the smell. That one has been really useful. So I just gonna mention this really simple method that you can apply because it's a cost effective. It's a really, really easy to make yourself. A lot of time we do not need an antidepressant to get rid of those conditions that we talked about above because those signs, symptoms, of course, are the early stage of depression, what they say. But there are many ways we can use an integrative way or holistic point of view to make this, to help yourself. And you can help your family. Is it okay, Ramatila?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, thank you, Dr. Yandin Last. I think it's a really, really helpful. Very practical. I think I'm sure many of you hear it very clearly, and I hope that you are able to use some of these great advices. And so once again, you know, like on the Facebook Live, there is, you know, the comments where people can make comments. And I think if you have a specific comments or questions wanted to ask to a specific speaker, please go ahead and just trying to ask that. But there's no promises that you're going to get the answer, but if maybe if they have to have time, they might look at it and they might think it's important to answer, then on the comment, maybe I will ask all of you to, if you can answer some of the questions to our cyber listeners. Thank you very much. And Dr. Punsola, please.
Okay, Laso Rinpoche, Karinche. Okay, so as continue, thank you very much, previous speakers. Yeah, they did such a wonderful. So when we get into the winter, as we said, the day is long, shorter, night is longer, and then all the heat is like intense into the internal. So which means is our body metabolism is also a little higher at the time. So that means is that whatever we eat, that just is faster than the other seasons. So for this reason of that, and then we say is the important to eat in generally three tastes. So in general, we have six tastes of food, like sweet, sour, salty, bitter, hot, and astringent. But in the winter cases, the first three tastes, which is sweet, sour, and salty, are more important. Why is important? Because it's this that the each taste has predominated by two elements. When we're looking like sweet taste is more predominated by the earth and the water element. And then the sour taste is fire and the earth element. And the salty is water and the fire element. So for that reason, as they say, is better winter to eat these three tastes. That does not mean is we should eat all in these three tastes, is not talking. Because its whole purpose is a balance, not to making is one is more or less. So when we're looking the what are they, the sweet taste? So there's a lot of food contains the sweet taste. in general, any other, any food has some partials of the sweet taste. But as a more predominated sweet taste is like all the meat product is a sweet taste. All the dairy product is a sweet taste, which is before adding the fermenting. Like cheese, yogurt is a different taste, but is like origin, like milk. And then also like the grains, like barley, wheat, rice, it also included like oat. It's a sweet taste. So in the winter time, also in the fruit, when we're looking fruit, like a banana is a sweet taste. Grape also like a sweet taste. So when we look in those sweet tastes, also is the sweet taste has the predominated by the earth and the water element, which means it's more heavy. So they help to grounding. And then the second one is the sour taste. Sour taste is all the fermented food is sour taste. And then also like origin, so like the pomegranate fruit is a sour taste. And there's some partial sweet, I mean the apple also like the sour taste. And then the salty is like in general, salt is a salty taste. So why we need to eat these three tastes in the winter? Because is these three tastes has more capacity to build the body. Because winter is like all the heat is inside. Digesting is very fast. So that means is once the food quality or the quantity is not strong or not enough, they can sort of like the consumed the and like constituents of the person. So that means is also they can losing, like when we're looking like saving money, they can lose instead of making out of it, as it can lose that the saved one. So for that reason, to protect the saved part, like the body constituents, and then to preventing from the indigestion problems. So this kind of reason is important to eat these three type of the food. And then also is the not only eating this kind of food, but also the another one is a proportion levels. So in general, we say is that the important to have the good breakfast and a good lunch, because is it the lunch and the breakfast to make it the whole day to move, and the light dinner. But in the winter comes, is that the dinner also is important to have a good dinner, because to making the long night. Otherwise, if the food is digested half of the night, and the rest of the night is the stomach is empty. When the empty time, what happened is increased the lung. And then that increase of the lung plus this that the heat can like consumed faster the body constituents. This is one. The another one, if the person is in generally weaker digestive system, that the increased the lung or the wind element or the air element in the night, and that can cause to decline the digestive heat and then permanent. Why? Because is that the when we're talking this, the air element has the six characteristics. The one of the characteristics of the air element or the lung element is like the rough, and then is cold, light. So, and then also subtle, hard, and mobile. So these six characteristics of the air element, the one of them is like rough and cold and mobile. So the cold, increase the cold can cause and extinguish that the heat, and then that can cause to the indigestion. As the previous Gishi Lobsala said, is the root of the internal disease is indigestion, or the indigestion is root of the internal disease. So if we cause or the problem of the indigestion, then they can cause all the internal disease, included like diabetes, arthritis, blood pressures, and the liver problem, gallbladder problem, so on and so forth. So this is the second part. And then the next part I will cover to make a short so back in summarize. Thank you.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much, Dr. Funsola. I think all of your advices are very, very practical, something that I think everybody can feel like they can change something, do something, prepare themselves. So very, very useful information. Thank you very much. And actually, I'm very excited about, it's amazing to sitting all expert people and sitting all in different part of the country and just feels like a very comfortable sitting here listening to all of your learning. This is fantastic. So I will not take time. So please, Lobsangla, you wanted to go ahead?
Sure. Hello, can you guys hear me now?
Yeah.
Okay, good, okay. Well, so I forgot to introduce myself earlier. So my name is Lobsang, and I was a Tibetan Buddhist monk for over 20 years, and currently I'm learning Chinese acupuncture, Chinese medicine, and I study Tibetan medicine with the Sodikang International. And so here, my friends earlier mentioned about the how to take care of yourself. So my part of the topic so now is I want to continue from my previous topic, and also which is connecting to my last friend's Dr. Pinzola's topic. So probably now you must familiar with all these three nyepas or three different personalities, like Lung disorder, Tibet disorder, Begin disorder. These are the principal three different personalities that we have. And so here today, I want to focus more on Lung disorder. So which is Dr. Yangdula mentioned about it, the quality of the characteristic of the Lung disorder, which is like very fidgety and talk active and very fickle mind and sensitive and so on. So most likely, like, you know, in Western medicine, they call like OCD kind of disease, or the people behavior, like, you know. And so therefore that case, if you apply the meditation and mindfulness on that one, so single pointed meditation would be very, very great, helpful. And through my own experience, my personal experience, and also I had encounter with the many stressful, depressive, people in the prison, and I just give this such a simple suggestion. They don't have any other facilities, so they really applied that one their own daily practice, and really helped. So which is the single pointed meditation, Shinne in Tibetan. So because how it helps is, you know, the wind disorder, which is very, very sensitive and very fickle, like always moving and very fidgety, and mind is always like constantly thinking. So because these are all like very light, kind of like moving kind of characteristic. So single pointed meditation is kind of like more like, you know, you're just kneeling down on the ground. So that's why when you meditate like single pointed meditation, so for example, when you have very, very that particular stressful situation, like keep constantly, you know, thinking crazy things in your mind and cannot settle down yourself. So try to, you don't need to have like, you know, very quiet and very peaceful place. So this we always looking for, like, you know, I would like to meditate, but I cannot find a nice, peaceful, quiet place. That if you find that particular facility you're looking for, you never find such a facility. So you just see wherever you are, just sit there quietly, and then visualize try to visualize on your breathing in and out. So as Rinpoche said earlier, so the air that we're breathing in and out, So we're just taking as a granted, actually. It's not that such a, it's very, very important for us. Like, you know, when to inhale and exhale. So that is the such a simple thing. And once you inhale, you cannot exhale. That means you're gone, right? So inhale, exhale very mindfully. And then try to visualize a very heavy objects. And so if you are not the spiritual practitioner, so there's no need to have a special or religious figure on it. So usually I just I just give the idea of in the prison, which they don't have any belief system, is the anchor which the ship holds. So that is kind of like heavy quality. So if you can visualize such like heavy quality objects, that helps you to anchor down to your fickle and your fidgety mind. So that is very, very important. And also my master's idea was, if you can visualize a gold color, even a gold, the material, the gold is even better, because gold is natural, the gold is very heavy. So that helps you to hold you down. And then also that helps you to fall asleep as well. So lung disorder, usually they're having a lot of insomnia problem. So insomnia problem is when you lay down in your bed and you cannot fall asleep. Just try to meditate that one. And also sometimes if it's a very noisy area, and just focus on the sound, whatever you can hear. And in the prison, there was like 60, 70 adult inmates in one big dorm, and their major complaint was, I cannot fall asleep because my dorm mates are very noisy. So I said, okay, just be there and don't be any judgmental mind. Just don't listen as like a noise, like a bad and good thing. Just listen as a sound. And if you can, just not just ignoring it, just try to focus on it and just listen without any judgmental mind. So that kind of like, you know, attitude can help you to settle your mind down and calm your mind down, and it gradually helps you to fall asleep. So that is very beneficial, and really for my own, the people in me, they really give me the credit. That's really helping for them in their really such a critical time in the prison. So that is my basic contribution for this time in this Facebook lifetime. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I think the last Lobsang last conversation was about the last one. I think we finished two rounds of circles. So I think maybe what we will do is just kind of wrap up a little bit our conversation. And the other day we thought we were talking, we said maybe, you know, we can do another time, you know, possibility of doing another time, maybe more specifically on pain, physical and emotional pain. So how does the, from the Tibetan medical point of view, the spiritual meditation point of view, how we can actually prevent a lot of our physical and emotional pain, and how we can manage better our pain, and probably we can, so we can learn a lot to kind of handle, so not to be affected by it. I know like there are many new findings through scientific researches are coming out on that, and then definitely Tibetan medicine and Tibetan spiritual tradition, Buddhism, has so much to offer in that. I think maybe we might consider as one time talk on this topic in the future. So I just want I'm going to open up this question to all of you and to see how all of you wanted to answer this. And of course that all of your conversation about from the Tibetan medical point of view, and particularly the balance and imbalances of the humors and five elements, and also Lobs and Las about, you know, the balancing of mind, single-pointed focus, helping our mind. So, you know, generally, as I was talking earlier, you know, the wind, it seems like a so important discussion. So even in higher teachings, like in the tantrism, like in the Burn tradition called Maju Sanji Jusum, and this text is talk about 9 different winds and 25 different winds and subcategory hundreds and thousands of different kind of winds, how these winds circulates through our body, our mind, every given moment, and then some subtler aspect. Now, I know like all of you from talking more point of view, particularly Dr. Punsola was talking more point of view about the food and behavior, seasons and taste of food, volume of food and so on in order to balance these elements or not. But what about, so let me say this, we are just maybe trying to keep the question simple. So these five principle of five element, more grosser level of the season and food and taste to a higher level, like five wind, Solung, Chinjulung, Trusiljulung, Chepjirjulung, Menyamjulung, and these higher winds, basically more related with the consciousness and more related with specific organs, how they flow in the body. And so what about these type of winds? And then especially what about like a winds, what we call Yishiji Delung Lad, and so wisdom lung, there's some notion of wisdom lung, Rigpi Ranglung, Yishiji Delung, Chinji Yinglung Sad, Yinglung Sad, Riglung Sad, Yelung Sad, there are many different, very, very kind of difficult concept of lung, but which is not, which really seems like a kind of affecting also our body and our mind, you know. So I always been very curious about does also, this is just, I'm going to pour a bunch of questions here and then maybe please feel free to talk anything that you feel comfortable. And also idea about in one single day, we breathe air, 11,000 liters of air every day. And among them, 550 meters of oxygen that we breathe every day in single day. Every time when we breathe one breath in, about 20% we breathe in and exhale 15%, and we keep 5% of oxygen in our lung, through our heart, through our circulation of blood to artery, to give every part of the body function, basically giving food to all the cells in the body. But how does this mind awareness can actually play? Does any relationship with oxygen and awareness, any relationship these, you know, the lungs that you are talking about oxygen or maybe when we talk in a tantra, all these different winds, maybe it has something go even beyond. Because some in the Buddhism sometimes teaching talk about, you're not, I think in some sense, not humans, we need to breathe oxygen, not necessarily every sentient being need to breathe oxygen. So these are just very open, open questions. Anybody wanted to say anything about these things? Just pull your hand and then I'll unmute you, okay?
Oh, Rinpoche, do you hear me? So I'm using it. All right. So the like you said, the lung has all kinds of levels. If you think a little bit bigger level, and you can think that's like hurricanes and those wind and those cyclones, all these things, those are the biggest level. And then comes to the medium, and which what we are breathing today is also a lung. And then a lung, and then if you goes deeper level, and then the lung connects, you know, like body and mind, and especially the mental activities, thoughts and emotions, all are dealing with the lung. All those lungs are very important. Once you have lung imbalance in your body, and this affects everything. Lung has like, as you mentioned, that we have five different categories of lung in terms of Tibetan medicine. And we call the song sing lung, it means life-sustaining wind that has a direct connection with our life. Whether you have a longer life or shorter life, or whether you have the healthier life or unhealthy life, it has direct connection with our life. And the life-sustaining wind is the located in the crown of our head, which we call crown chakra. And then it passes down to the chest, and then it also responsible for the clearing our mind, clearing the five sense organs. And if you go a little bit deeper level than that, then the life-sustaining wind, Songzhen Gilong, when there is great practitioners, they use those energies to gain the energies without even food. They can stay very long times. Like in ancient time in Tibet, there are many yogis, practitioners. They stay in a cave and they just take those energies from the environment. And then some of those practitioners even can just one spoon of flowers, or just one day. And then rest of the energies they take from the wind energies. So those are, and then there are also things that practitioners can use those energies to develop their mind, to gain more knowledge, to eliminate all the what they call the negative affliction emotions. And
so, for example, idea of generally that wind is carrying oxygen through lung, through heart, to rest of the body to give food to the cell. So my question here is it possible from Tibetan medical point of view or from tantric point of view that wind not only carry like oxygen, but wind can also carry a specific qualities of consciousness such as love? This is a crazy questions here. Can wind can carry a love in the wind and bringing into the heart, or wind can carry specific qualities for the brain, food for the brain, food for the heart, food for the kidneys, spleen, liver. So what does wind carries?
Yes, Rinpoche, wind carries almost everything. I can say almost everything. We have, as I mentioned, we have life-sustaining wind that deals with our mind. And then we have pervasive wind that deals with our circulation, mainly located in the heart chakra. And it deals with our heart. It also can give benefit to the heart when it's in the state of balance. And then it's also bring oxygens and the nutritions to all over our body. And then we also have another wind called fire accompanying wind, which directly deals with our digestion systems. Not only digestion, it also deals with the metabolism, right? So then also we have another wind that's called descending wind that deals with the fetus, holding the fetus up when it comes to the 9 month, push out and pushing the feces out, urination. And then, like when you have like intercourse, like sexual intercourse, and some they have problems with, the impotency, right? And then that's also many times because of those, the descending wind. So wind can do almost everything. The mental activities, and especially wind can, there are a lot of levels that, meditate on the wind energy, Tsa, Lung, Tigli, the channel and the energy and the essence of nutritions. So The great yogis, they use all those three energies to gain the development of our mind, to purify our mind and to attain the enlightenment. So,
okay, thank you.
Okay, so Dr. Ondila answered one of my questions already. So basically it will definitely carry the nutrients. And I think also because the nutrients transmit through the lung, it's a connect with the brain, it helps to release the neurotransmitters. We just don't have any such a research done saying by doing this, then by satisfying Lung, then you're releasing such and such a neurotransmitters that we don't know. But definitely there's a connection that I can kind of see through the function of the Lung. And going back to the talk that you asked me earlier, the Solung and Ninglung, I skipped that because that was going to be the more advanced stage at that time. So basically, Solung will be more focused on your mental related issues. So all the symptoms we have been talked. And Ninglung will be connected with our cardiovascular health. So Dr. Undula already made that connection. So nevertheless, how they look very similar in certain way, but they also can be really different, but they share one common sign and symptom on patient is they get a really sensitive on the crown of the head. They feel really sore on the chest, right on the sternum, and also thoracic vertebrae and C5 and 6. The reason is those are the heart chakra, what we call Tapji Lung. So that's the center for that. So when you point those points, unless they have injury from mechanical reason, then if they have a soreness, those are the answers for us to conclude their condition is connected with the Solung and Ninglung. So we use, what we do is when we do either the hormone treatment or when we do the breathing exercise, what's going on really is when you're really shocked, so when you're really anxiety, anxious, panic attack, you lock yourself so you're not breathing in. So when you're not breathing, you actually cut all the oxygen going up and down physiologically, right? But in Lung, you're actually closing down the movement of the Lung. So when you do a moment when you start to do the deep breathing in, once after you do 3 times, like that, 3 times, once you do that, that it carries the oxygen up and down. So we just use a different language in Western medicine. We say oxygen is moving, but in Tibetan medicine, we're letting the Lung to move, moving according to
whatever. So question, for example, if you're breathing in, we have like a rhythmic breath.
Yes.
And usually most of the time we are trying to breathe through our nose. Mm-hmm. And it's basically air containing maybe some percentage of oxygen. So for the Tibetans, once you breathe in this air, which contains some oxygen primarily, and maybe other things, but once it gets in, then when it comes to where does they become more specifically one of the 5 lungs? Like, for example, where does this breath, rhythmic breath, or this air boundary where it becomes like a Solung when it in the crown? I mean, in the Tibetan medicine, since in the crown, in some of the Maju Tantra, they talk Solung in the heart, but it doesn't matter. So when they enter there, they become a Solung? Sure. Or what is coming from out and where it transforms something into a Solung? How does that work?
So that someone can answer, maybe Punzo.
Maybe Punzo, yeah.
Okay, thank you. So I think it's in general, when we looking the our body, a mind, and then also the 5 element, I think there is not only one single. They so like more like a gross, more like a material levels, more subtle levels, and also more fine subtle levels. So in our body, like the physical body, regenerating is we eating food and then abstracting the nutrients and that nutrient to regenerate our physical body. But also this is not the only way of the getting the essence of the 5 elements. So the eating food, digesting, abstracted essence is one of the getting 5 elements. But also the one important is to get the 5 essence of the 5 elements through the breathing. So when we look in the breathing, is the commonly officially is yes, through the nose and the mouth. But also in the old, our body pours. This also is the place where is the breathing, to regenerating or the refreshing the body system. So through this, that the special through the inhaling, when we abstracting, when we get all the essence of the five elements, and especially if you do with the conscious, with the specific way, so that the inhaling through the inhale, the five element is not the physical level, is a more sort of like a subtle level. So that will regenerate also more like a subtle level of the five element. So this is a way of the subtle element regenerating through the more breathing, more through the inhaling way. But when we're looking this, the either we call is the Soglung or the Ninglung. So the Soglung and the Ninglung is the both is taking the place is that the same sort of like region, because is that the, as the previous doctor said, is that the Songjinlung, this that the life sustaining we call the Songjinlung is located in the crown chakra. And then this that the ascending lung is locating in the heart chakra. So this Songjin lung is come down to the heart chakra, and the heart chakra goes up to towards to the crown chakra region, ending through the nose area. So this that the we important as we said this that the jugular notch, or the we call this the throat chakra, is important because intersections. And then the another one, this the heart chakra, it is a very important. Why this is important? Because is that the lung tipa pegan, like the one of the tipa we call is determined tipa, tipa dubji, accomplishing tipa is located in the heart chakra. And then this the lung which call is like the pervading lung also is located in the heart chakra, like the kapji lung. And they also did the supporting pegan tenji also locating in this the heart chakra. So for that reason, this is we consider is like a central station, sort of like it's very important. So for that reason, either is the Tantrism or the Buddhism or the Tibetan medicine, we consider this heart chakra is very important. As Dr. Yang mentioned before this, that the potency also mainly we using this kind of chakra. So this is also, I think, so like a conclusion of my topic, like the winter comes, everything condensed, is we have tendency more like depressions. A lot of people get like depression problems. Also in the compare with the summer and the winter, people go to see the healthcare more winter than the summer. Why? Because that the wind, because it's sort of like a little like slow down, is not move as like the fast, because is that the nature of the winter. For that reason is people get more tendency to depression. Also this is that the lack of the air.
Lazo, tuche ane. So thank you everybody. So now maybe what I'll just say, maybe do the conclusion here, and then I think people who, all the English listener who listen in English, then they don't have to be part of it. Then unless they wanted to hear Tibetan, beautiful Tibetan language, which doesn't make any sense, you're welcome to stay. So first of all, I wanted to really, really appreciate, I know all of you personally, so it was nice to see friends, but doing something hopefully meaningful for everybody who's listening. And so I want to thank member Kunga Wandula, member Kaza Yangdunla, and member Panso Amula, and the Gishi Lobzan Tseringla, and Tama La Tsamtresh Dele. Thank you so much for being here with all your precious times to be being, you know, being available and giving some support to our cyber community worldwide. And I'm sure they benefit. And I encourage everybody to write down, comment, whatever you feel, whatever you want to hear next time, and whatever some specific questions that you have to specific speakers. And I'm requesting them to visit some of these comments, and if they have little time, they will answer. But if you do not get answer, so you can also that breathe it out. So just in terms of scheduling next week, next Tuesday, I just did a one Facebook yesterday call. You know, many of you know the pith instruction. I've been every now and then I've been doing this, but lately not been very good with traveling. But I just managed to do one yesterday, and I will do one tomorrow next week on Tuesday, and I will write the title and timing, everything. But then I will be traveling again, going to Brazil and then back to India. Then I'm not sure how frequently I will be able to do it, not. But I will definitely let everybody know how frequently we were able to do it, because we had such a great team with TWR Facebook Live. It was really, really helping a lot. So also wanted to thank TWR Facebook Live, and particularly Anya, who has been our host and helping, not this time and every time when we did the online thing. So I think yeah, so then everybody who are listening here, not hearing Tibetan, so please, you don't have to continually sit here. And so Kungala, maybe if you wanted to continuously speak a little bit about, in Tibetan, so that all our Tibetan audience, so basically just summarizing from the beginning to end, little introduction, little, particularly if there's things that they can really apply. Please,
welcome. Kazurajigis, Luginet, and Semginet, and a Ludan Semnigin, Jereg, Cortic, Goliada, Yawshuchun, so any, and Danganzu, Gan, my share, Shabbat, the Manche, Chichina, Inji King, and that Inger, the Inji, my Kemba, Zolia, and Magic, and Anzuchi, Tordu should soon to Nas, and do send Rubicis, Sunsiaza, Taring Anzu, Dinma, Dagger share, the Zoe, the Semginazek, Corti, Shetig, Yore, and Semginaza, they are Semginazas lying to Tanganzu, but Luda, Zawin, and Jawame, the Tindish, my Imbache, Luda, Semnigin, Jawa, you deba.
Zawadi, Dangzi Maribala, two deba, Maribatia, any
Rimuchi Kamana Chikantinato even.
Shugo Samsu Karsana Tanda Namad Samagi Kamananjo Jirvala.
Nare
Chena Konama Samagi Kamananjo T. Ningdi Ningdichi Konama
Losnos Rimuchi. O Tati Chesata Tindichi Latusia, or the Nate and the Termashea Tindito, which in Egg, touching Semginegi, Kudan Ken, Anichi Netan, Dishubri, and Tineta. Ngazu ke semine de lule ya member che ada lug ne de semla de yonya gi gen zo ro de ngazu lu da sem ni jo go palan je wa tu jang ge de juang as ne ri juwa shi se as ge yor kabra kabra ti ge ge ta tu kya ge yor es ngazu le ga ya ga che bi ne ge lug le ga ya ga che da lu de ta ta sem ki bo la so ba chung bi na lu de ta chung na sem ki bo yonya ta sem ki bo chung bi na lu de ta yonya gyum zen zo de kunyi ge palan je wa tu gen de juwa shi se as ge yor kabra kabra juang as ya shi go se ge yor ta mix ge che bas ke cha ge Young and Jusuku Kalamale, Becatulia, Juasiam Nasia, the Lung Chiba Pagans and Nubasum Lashe de Giori, Tanda Dodo Gibi in a Chigbari, or the Tinditching to Cinema Shubi, then that the old young and Zutan that the Mjipunzo Malagi, Carsons or Shubin, and Zu Gungetusu, Anichi, and Zu Supulia, Pachi Katachim, Harbardo, and Anzuki, Semla, Yangi, Tang, Yamango Shuichi, Lunda, Jawa Indeba. Gunga Naza, the Lunga Naza, the Sai, you know, Gunga Yang was said to have never covered Yaga Yalan, Yaga Tindiki came today, Yungres, Kains and Aranzolia, Chikazore, Gundu, Pegin, Kuntan, Anichi Lung Koto Sabate, Yaga, the Jiga Kadulim, the Yatang, and the Indrik Sornan, the Yang Yores, Kong, the Sunso, and the Natural Yangu Gasan Lagi, Jansu Gasan Lagi, Tatin Mazong, Aranzo Horgi Metas, the Horgi Metas Layundu, Mazu Konyunum, the Chimber Jibe Lomas, Lavitu. Then Zadita Konyuni, the Dungjang, Azu Lungan as a Yube Katuri, Lunga Gange Yube Katuri, Nimakuba Tedek Gange, Yang Azokar, Sem Namtachiata, Sem Sabiata, Tandameva, Sem Makibacha, Lungatat, and the Yube Kadula, and a Kanzo Tibetan Zadi, Zadi Shipship Tuna, and a Konyutan Shipship Tuna, and a Jag Sangregnala, Jija, Dum Tabosuja, Gur, and a Chizu Sanglaya, Manemiare, Gamachik Nechi, Gamani, Pazala Tinayari, the Nang Azuchi, the Yagung Sangil and Nemiare, the Nang Azuki, Nabata Tubale. Nemiari, Taranashing on Zupango, the Sangla Nemiari, the Nail Lakbat and Kangbeg teeth into Samalaya, did Num Sabojabegeta, Konegi, Nemia, Otindigitol, Sunso, Tin, Chebina, and then on Zubuka, Lung to the man, Jomdria, and Lute, but a simple Yonyala Tindiki, Pendo Chamboyores, and the Sunso, that Dine, and the Tenda Gishin Lobsan like Karsumbina, and the Yamlangatone, Gumjum Yamlangatone, and then on Zuka sent my shirt to Shirche to Yata. Hagbardu Dingzang, Chizo Nalia, Tachi, Sangasin, Sabotan, Ketra, and Tindig Mambo, Yombe Katulia, and on the Pezun Karasun Sumina Kongi, and on the Keg, Tratin, the Yayun, and meeting the control lunch in the and a cat, Sabotan, Jab Dwayanchi, Robot, Tobotomoki, Jabiatan, Tindig Yombe Katu, Kranchi, Zonga, Naliata, Lobzin Chibe, Yamyong, Shisha Betone, and the Zombakashi, Robotzo Keg, Tojo, to the same Makiba Yungu, same Shinne, Tugum, to Kanga Yungu to City, and Kongi Lamdon Karanaso Shubina, Kerangi, Jakha, Yomba Tilea, Tangyum Gatone, Yagata, Dugata, Hondo Shedang, Ayelos of Kaya Machabe, the Tangyum Gatone, Jagai, Batilla, Yen, Devina, Kerangasem Nalia, Hondo and Shedang, I guess, Sim Tuya, Yuchagimares, Jagai, but the Quadrajila, Chasha, and Idilia, and that Yashuchum be in the music in the Chasha. Today, Chen Chebina, and Sim Ganalo Kondong, I guess, Shedan, the Makiala, Kandare, and Tunda, Dodo, the Chirugi, Takanda, Nezu, Kandichum be in a Zodi, Sozu Nanga Sim de la Rale, Sozu Nanga Sim Ganamdo, and the Piggy Dugata, Yagas, Yoche. Digi, Rana Dungetig, but this soon so on Tigital Gamina. What the Tidito was it having on to the same, Tinamatang make Sumia, so do it in the Chuso, Stang it in Matang make it in this shoe. Lazo Rubuce, Gatinche.
Lazo, Rarawandu la pet tu che halle lege pet yagu shuji song song pet tangma nyingdi nyingdi dodo dodo chikwa mahala pa pet yagu shuji song na song pe karin che ane tando te la ngaranzo tina la tanda ngodep tedong nge gergi ngodep tedong nena la pepe nyengen kasi yomengi haku me kasi nyengen yobi ina ane tanda poge ti jabi tona tindegi pento odobu tindi dugu yungu do na Ani tiga je pentol dos, tindih cerita labja ini re, labdoena ini re, samsuna ini re, nauru nas, ya jam-jam ngojo tindih ngodep call lega tu tindih cerita kala kaga ni, ane kaga matian do na, digi de ini, jam pengi yo na, jik pengi dos jisumbaya na ngojo la ini samshu pade aje re, ta pengi mendo na mixi pengi mendo masung na digi re. Ane jam dengan petu nanti kerjakan itu. Last one tu je check kering check sama ane check nama sama ane jadi thangbo nala kumpul ya nang ojo mixeki thangbo nala ojo tanda kharsore me suk rang kola pain rang kola cik cethuna ya buat ane ojo gear di dewa sih show.
Last one tu je check.
Tanda ni ada nala pain ane landa jago gue duna. Ane cina leh jam matup na ini, korang jo komen tu jo signa ti saja ni, ya boleh jere tinggal.
Laso terus je rambutnya. Laso.
Laso
terus je rambutnya.
Terus.
Laso.
Anjala terus.